Hello, I hope you're well. My name's Serena. This is Hands Free Yoga. You won't need anything else other than yourself and your mat today. So when you're ready, come to stand at the top of the mat and I shall meet you there. So coming to find Tadasana, so whatever that means for you, so either toes touching, heels slightly apart, or just have them hip distance apart, whatever's comfortable for you and your body today. Once you've found your Tadasana, your version of Tadasana, root the feet into the floor. You may feel like you want to just lift the toes up a little bit and then separate them and lower them back down to the ground. Feel nice and grounded. Coming up through the legs, start to engage the quads, engage the thighs. Maybe have a slight external rotation. Tucking the tailbone down. Pulling up through your Mula Bandha, so your pelvic floor area, perineum if you're a guy. Tucking the belly button back towards the spine, or the other bandha is engaged. Relaxing the shoulders down the back, stacking shoulders on top of hips. Lifting chin so it's parallel to the floor. Grow a little bit taller through the crown of the head, palms face forward, energy through the fingers. Let's take two cleansing breaths here. Inhale through the nose. Sigh out through the mouth. One more, inhale through the nose. Exhale, sigh out through the mouth. Really nice. Just return back to inhaling and exhaling through the nose now. And let's jump in on your next inhale. Reach the hands up overhead. Your gaze comes to your thumbs. As you exhale, lower the body forward over the legs. Find your Uttanasana. Let's do that three more times. Inhale, reach the arms up. Bring the torso up. Arms reach overhead. Exhale, closing hands down through heart center. Reach down towards the floor. Two more. Inhale, reach up, extend the spine. Grow through the entire body. Relax shoulders. Exhale, fold over the legs. Find your Uttanasana. Allow the arms to hang and drop to the floor. Last one. Inhale, reach the hands up and overhead. Exhale, fold over the body. That's hanging out Uttanasana here. You can grab hold of each elbow if that's comfortable for you, or just allow the arms to flop down, however they do. Have a micro bend in the knees. Just for now, as we warm up the body, you don't want to overstretch. One more breath here. And then on your next inhale, shift your weight over to that right foot and then gently pick the left foot up and towards the body. Feel free to place the hands at heart center. You're in this weird half flamingo position. Really nice. And when you're ready, with control, start to extend that left foot to the back of the mat, plant the toes down onto the mat, and coming up to your high lunge. Option to keep hands at heart center, otherwise lift them up overhead. We're here for two breaths. Inhaling. Exhaling through the nose. Feel free to use your Ujjayi breath if it's in your practice. Last one. Really nice. If your hands are up overhead, close them down back through heart center. Shift the weight backwards slightly to give yourself a little bit of momentum to bring that left foot to meet right at top of the mat. On your next inhale, reach the hands up overhead. Exhale, fold the body over. Really nice. When you're ready on your inhale, shift weight over to left side. Again, option to bring hands to heart center. And then slowly start to pick that right leg up and bring the heel in towards the glute. Squeeze it as much as you can before extending the toes to the back of the mat. With control, place the foot down onto the mat. Come to your high lunge. Again, options with the hands. Stay here. Or release hands up overhead, making sure you're relaxed in the shoulders. Closing rib cages. Two breaths. And exhale. Last one. Really nice. If your hands are up, bring them back down to heart center. Give yourself a little shift back before pushing off the back toes to arrive at your Tadasana. Straighten in the legs. If your toes are not touching, just shuffle the feet so the toes are touching, heels slightly apart. On your inhale, bend the knees, sweep the arms up overhead. Let's find our chair pose, our Utkatasana. On your next inhale, sweep the arms down and back behind you. Exhale, bring them up in line with the ears. Two more like that. Inhale, release the hands down, trace the floor. Exhale, bring them up overhead. Feel the burn in the thighs. Last one. Inhale. Exhaling. Really nice. Closing through heart center. Picking up the left leg, step left foot to the back of the mat. Find that high lunge again. Again, options to bring hands overhead. Inhale here. As you exhale, pivot on the ball of that back foot to turn it so it's parallel to the short edge of the mat. Arms come parallel to the floor. We're in our warrior two. Hold here for three breaths. Inhale. Gazes over front hand. Exhale. Maybe just have a quick glance to see if this back hand is in line with the front. And then when you're ready, you're going to bring this left hand down the back of the left leg. Reach the right hand up and back. We're in our reverse warrior. Inhale here. As you exhale, sink a little deeper into that front leg if you can. Last breath. And then moving your way back to a warrior two. Straighten that front leg. That should feel nice in the room. That should feel really nice on that thigh. Turn right toes to face long edge of the mat. With our hands placed on our hips, take an inhale. Lift the chest up. As you exhale, fold over the legs. We're in our wide leg forward fold. Option to release the arms down to the floor, but feel free to keep them hovering off the ground. Or maybe grab hold of each elbow. Just to avoid yourself placing any weight on them. Pressing into the outside edges of the feet. Releasing the spine, starting from the lumbar spine. Lifting tailbone up towards the ceiling. Last breath. And then slowly coming back up with the torso. Maybe bend the knees to allow that to happen nice and easily. Release the hands if you had hold of each elbow. Turning right toes back to the top edge of the mat. Again, shift weight back. Press yourself forward to the top. Find your Tadasana. Let's go on the opposite side. So releasing right leg to the back of the mat with control. Come to your high lunge. Take an inhale. Exhale, twisting open. So pivoting on the ball of that back foot this time. Placing the foot so it's parallel to the short edge of the mat. Bend nice and deep into the front leg. We're in our warrior two for three. For two, stuck in knee over ankle. And one. Really nice. Release this right hand down the back leg. Left hand comes up and over in our reverse warrior. Really extend through this whole left side of the body. Last breath. Really nice. Come back through your warrior. Push your weight back into that back foot. Step to the top of the mat. Release the legs. If you need to wiggle the legs, wiggle them out. Moving on. When you're ready on your inhale, bring this left knee off the floor, the foot off the floor. Bring the knee into the body. Give it a nice big squeeze with the arms if you want to. Otherwise, you can just use it nice and actively with the leg. Bring hands to heart center. And then slowly start to push the foot away from you. Pushing with the heel. We're coming into our warrior three, staying nice and grounded in that front leg. Option to do any variation you have with the arms in your warrior of three. Feel free to eagle the arms. Maybe release them out in front of you. Last breath. Keep pushing the heel. Nice. Slowly start to lower that foot to the back of the mat. Let's find our high lunge again. Really nice. Take an inhale here. As you exhale, open back to our warrior two. Nice and deep. We should feel a lot warmer in the body, so see if you can go a little bit deeper this time. Take an inhale. Exhale, straighten that front leg. On your inhale, reach forward. Imagine someone's pulling this right arm. As you exhale, release the right hand down to the shin or the ankle. If it's comfortable for your hands and your arms today, feel free to take an Ashtangi bind if that's in your practice. But again, avoid placing any weight on this hand. If it helps, maybe wrap the hand around the torso. You can do that with the top arm just to stop yourself placing anything down. Last breath. When you're ready, use that core engage. Pull yourself back up to standing. Shift the weight back to push yourself to the top of the mat. Ready, just go on the other side. Bring in right leg off the floor. Bring in knee into chest. Again, if it's comfortable for your body today, maybe give it a little extra pull. It can be with the forearms, if that's more comfortable, or just really engage in that thigh to get it nice and high. Hands come to heart center. When you're ready, slowly start to shift that weight back from that heel. Push it all the way back. Push it back. Imagine you're pushing a wall away from you, bringing the torso parallel to the floor. Find something in front of you to focus on. Again, option to play around with your arms here. Last breath. Really nice. With control, start to lower that back foot to the mat. Find your high lunge. Take an inhale here. As you exhale, twisting open to find our warrior two. Again, let's see if we can get a little bit deeper this time. One more breath here, inhaling. And exhaling, really nice. Take an inhale. Exhale, straighten the front leg as you inhale. Reach as far forward as you can. Exhaling, release this left hand down to wherever you've done so on the opposite side. If you release the hands around the belly, feel free to do that here, making sure we're still pressing open with this right shoulder. One more breath, pulling up through the quad of this left thigh. Really nice. Use that core, pull yourself back up to stand and shift weight backwards and then step to the top of the mat. Again, wiggle anything out you need to. As you're doing that, shuffle feet as wide as the mat. Bring hands together at heart center, slowly lower the bum. Once you're about halfway, shift the weight over to the left toes, release right shin from underneath you to sit down and then doing so on the left side, finding your rock pose. Really engage that core to get there. Relaxing hands into lap. Start to calm the breath down. The hard work is over. Maybe bring yourself to turn the corners of the mouth upwards slightly. You've even closed the eyes. Consciously start to slow the breath down. So you may try to make the inhales and exhales a little longer, maybe by adding one breath count onto the end of it. Calm the body down. Releasing the legs as we're in this pose, which stretches out the quads. As always, you are welcome to stay here for as long as you need to today. Thank you so much for practicing with me, and I shall see you soon.